suggested the UK could welcome more than 200,000 Ukrainians hoping to escape from the conflict. Yesterday, the Home Secretary told MPs only half that number would be able to join their families in Britain. The UN Refugee Agency says 660,000 people have left Ukraine for neighbouring countries. Also this afternoon, the Queen has carried out two virtual audiences at Windsor Castle after cancelling some engagements last week. She spoke to the new ambassadors from Andorra and Chad. Her Majesty was diagnosed with coronavirus last weekend, with the panic saying she had mild to light symptoms. In the city a short time ago, the FTSE 100 was trading down 80 points at 73.77. The pound might have gone by 33 and then euro 20. And we see weather outbreaks of rain moving in from the south, heavier in the far southwest. Plenty of sunshine elsewhere, highs of 10 degrees. From Global Syndrome for LBC, I'm Amelia Fox.
could intervene more. It could, of course, decide to enforce a no-fly zone over Ukraine. That's a very different question to whether it should, given that Russia is, of course, a state with a significant number of nuclear weapons. Nuclear weapons that Vladimir Putin has made threats to use in recent days. Given that a no-fly zone would effectively be a declaration of war by the West, by NATO, on Russia. Boris Johnson was asked directly, he was asked by Ukrainian commentator Dario Kalenyuk, why NATO is not doing war, why, she said, isn't a no-fly zone something that you're looking more seriously? Boris Johnson said, he had to be honest, that wasn't something that NATO could do. And I said,
crash would descend, and this approach is based on the strongest security compliance. Mr. Speaker, these measures have been designed to enable swift implementation, and that is the point, swift implementation, without the need for legislation or changes to immigration laws. The Ukrainian people need help in Ukraine. I've also set out phase two of our bespoke humanitarian support package for the people of Ukraine. 73. And Priti Patel in the Commons talked about a huge national effort being required to help the hundreds of thousands, likely, of Ukrainians who will be coming to the UK. She clearly alluded to it being on a temporary basis for the vast majority. We'll see, won't we? It's hard to know how the event will unfold, but the idea clearly at the beginning there is for people to have rest, life and safety. One of these things sorts itself out, and she said the work they would go back to a free and democratic Ukraine. And she talked about the Ukrainian diaspora of people in the UK being central to this effort, with British people and Ukrainian not all and businesses and charities also being central to it too. So it went further than we expected, which is excellent news.
Outbreaks of rain moving in from the south, heavier in the far southwest, plenty of sunshine elsewhere, highs of 10 degrees. after treatment, other serious conditions should have been ruled out by a doctor. If you're suffering from the symptoms of an enlarged prostate, like more frequent trips to the bathroom or poor flow, then eMobile's once-a-day prostacyte capsules is a convenient choice of herbal remedy. Always read the leaflet. eMobile's prostacyte.
Zelensky of Ukraine received a standing ovation this morning in the European Parliament when he addressed it by Zoom. It went on for about a minute and a half, the standing ovation, and he said prior to it, prove you are on our side, which is, I suppose, for us as ordinary individuals, what we're trying to do in myriad ways, isn't it? Let's focus in on the help we can give to Ukrainian refugees in any way, not just those who come here. When they do. Arabella's call from Ilminster. Hello, Arabella.
Hi.
You've been thinking about the sponsorship element of
willing to take people in anyway, if we were allowed to. And I was thinking I'd start collating some information of people I knew who were willing to take people in.
Mm.
And then, of course, I just literally heard that Priti Patel statement. So, you know, I'm just sort of thinking, we're all being given permission.
Spare bedrooms, Arabella.
I've got a couple, and my friend's got a spare bedroom, so, you know, that's sort of where, you know, I thought that's...
Hello, Arabella.
Yeah, I'm sorry, I can't hear you.
Oh, sorry.
Thank you.
I spoke to Dennis just before I came on air. They travelled by road from Kharkiv on the far northeastern side of Ukraine, so the Russian border.
Which has now been heavily shelled.
Which is heavily shelled today, and sadly Dennis's parents are still there as well. All the way across the breadth of Ukraine, it's a big country, all the way across the breadth of Ukraine to get safety of them. But if he and she naturally want them.
Because they can offer them shelter, indeed. You spoke to Dennis Zubi earlier. And this is a little bit of what he's going, he had to say, but of course he's clearly interviewed for the after two.
Shiva, I probably about something shifty.
Businesses will have the opportunity to sponsor people to come to the UK, but in terms of the family members, the extended family members who want to come, that's not subject to visa restrictions. It's not subject to.
Getting them here, whether it's sending an aircraft to get them.